everyone, welcome back to my channel. And after watching all the makeup favorites, let's move on to some skincare, hair care, hand care, nail care, whatever is related to our skin, body, hair. Today I'm here with my 2019 favorites. Now for today's video, I'm not wearing any kind of makeup just because it's a proper skincare video where I'm going to show you my favorites. And secondly, I want it to be really raw. I don't want to wear a lot of makeup and then do my skincare. I generally do my skincare with very minimalistic makeup or no makeup. So if you don't like seeing me like this, then you can jump on to some other video. But you want to know something very interesting and how I'm keeping my skin healthy and glowy, stay tuned because you're going to discover some very interesting, very promising products. Before I jump into some exciting, interesting, specifically skincare, I would love to show something really worked amazing for my hair. Now I have very restrictive, very promising products for my hair. My shampoo, conditioner are like the ones which I've been using past 4 years. They are not changed. Instead, in between, I do try a lot of different products because it's my work. I like to try a few new things. But I will do a dedicated hair care routine where I show you my holy grails. Nothing much interesting or new to show, that is why I'm not touching on shampoo or conditioner. Moving on, I tried two new products in 2019. One is the leave-on serum, the vitamin E1. Amazing, lovely. I don't like a lot of serums for my hair personally because I have long hair, and secondly, it do get a little sticky in between. If you see up, don't mind because I am filming this video thrice because both the times I was out of focus, so I just have to check that I'm not out of focus. So moving on, this serum really worked because firstly, I was never interested in buying the leave-on one because I was like, pata nahi kaam karega ki nahi. But then when my Tony and Guy was out of stock and I bought some more different brands, I didn't like them also, and then later I was like, let me just get this one and try, give a shot. So I bought a smaller version first and then I went ahead for this one because I liked it. My hair really likes the texture of it. It doesn't get oily or frizzy in between. So this worked really well for my hair. If you're looking for something nice, subtle, simple and inexpensive for your hair, then you can give a shot. If I'm not saying that it worked well for me, it would have worked well for you. Maybe a few of you will say no, it made your hair dry. So it depends person to person. Moving on, lot of oils I tried this year because I had a terrible hair fall and now it is under control. The under control product is the Positive Root Therapy Onion Oil Advanced. Now I was looking for an onion oil and I got it from Amazon. Now on Amazon, if you search by just saying like onion oils or avocado oil or olive oil, a lot of options will drop down, and it's not that only known brands will pop up. There are some non-recognized brands or very underrated brands also will pop up. So in that non-recognized brand, this brand popped up and I looked onto YouTube for some reviews and people were really happy with the results. So I was like, let's just invest on a good oil. So this retailed for 1,000 rupees, but it really worked well. It really did what it had to. So it really helped me reduce my hair fall and regrowth was there. So yeah, this is another interesting hair care product I used during 2019, and once it is over, I will definitely repurchase. In that review I have done on the Positive Root Therapy, I will link it down, or you can just go on to my playlist review of products. You'll get all the reviews related to many other products. Now it's time for some interesting skincare. Before I jump into some moisturizers, serums and all that, let me just show you the two makeup removal skincare products I love the most during 2019. Now first one is quite a surprise to me also. It's the Nivea Micellar Skin Breathe Micellar Cleansing Water. This is somewhat like this. Now this, you can see already, I'm already here. It's gonna be over in few days. I absolutely love this for my skin. I have the Garnier Micellar Water also, but personally speaking, this is the one I have used the most. Like in one go, I have been using only this. I didn't jump onto my Garnier one. Once it is over, definitely I will use my Garnier ones, but this really did the job well. If you're a person who have doubts to use Garnier one, get this one. I don't think so, you will have a disappointment. I use this for my lip swatch videos and removing some very dirty eye makeup at times if I don't want to go in with my cleansing balm. Saying cleansing balm. The another product which I absolutely love was my Herb Day cleansing cream aloe by Face Shop. I've done a full comparison video, review video with the Clinique Take the Day Off balm. Now this made it to my 2019 favorites because this is the second tub. This is the newest purchase. Okay, if you don't believe, just so you saw that the cream I have already started using. This is the second tub and I feel that I will be repurchasing it soon because I do love using this to remove all of my makeup. This gets my makeup on point out, leaving my skin hydrated, supple for the day. Okay girls, now there's a power off, so definitely you'll see a little fluctuation in the light. So let's move on to some interesting serums which I have been using in 2019, and two of them are something which I have been using past 3-4 years now. The one which I absolutely swear by, and I think if you're a combination to oily skin you should definitely put your hands on this one. This is the Body Shop Tea Tree Anti Imperfection Daily Solution. Oh my god, if you are on a hunt to repair your skin, get out of all those acne marks and everything, get this one. I'm saying it because I have been using it past 3 years. This is not, I don't know which number of bottle I'm using. At least I buy this bottle twice a year because I use it every day with all the other skincare I try. So this is really amazing. Love, get it. Moving on, that's not the only serum I use or I give my skin. The other one is by Innisfree. This is the Innisfree Green Tea Seed Serum. Tell me about it. No, I don't think so. Anybody would hate this serum. Everybody loves it. This is one of their hot selling serums. Secondly, this is my fourth bottle by itself. I absolutely love the finish of it. It's good, it's very good quality, made for combination to oily to dry skin. If you're a very dry skin, you can still try it, and if you're oily skin, you can still try it. It's very good. I'm not just saying because it is Innisfree, I'm saying it because this is one of the products by Innisfree. It is good. Like, I try a lot of Face Shop products, but if I have to buy a serum, it has to be by Innisfree and it has to be the green tea. So amazing, lovely, it works really well on my skin. Next up is a very interesting product. It's a vitamin C serum. Now this is the anti-aging serum, advanced serum by Derma Essentia. Now I was just scrolling on Nykaa and I was looking for a vitamin C. I had O3 in my mind, but then when I saw this, I was like, let me give a shot to this one. And this is really lightweight. It will just sink into your skin like a water and you will not even feel that you applied something. The best use of it, it can be in the morning after your cleansing, before you apply your serum on your face. I like to do it like that, or during the day also if I end up washing my face like twice or thrice. Instead going in with a serum, I like to go in with vitamin C. Don't overuse a product on your skin, it may start giving you some other problems. So restrict your usage on certain products. Like serums, you can use it like twice, thrice a day. With other products, moisturizer, vitamin C serum, or any other serum which you're using, you should know how much and when to use it. So yeah, this one really made it to my 2019 because it really worked well on my skin and I could see vast difference in my skin appearance also. It did what it had to, so amazing. If you're looking for a vitamin C serum, you can give a shot to this one. Definitely now this is off the chart because I should have been showing you moisturizers, but I have a lot of moisturizers to show you guys. So what we'll do, we'll finish up the other steps first and then at the end I'll show you all the moisturizers I enjoyed the most in 2019. The first product which I have in my hand is the Mamaearth under eye cream. Oh my god, from the time I've got this, I've been just using this one. Apart from this, I've not touched any other eye cream in my closet. Yes, I do have the mango seed one, the Laneige one, the Innisfree one. Yes, the Innisfree one, I do tend to use it because I love it. But the Mamaearth under eye cream, very, matlab, so fast, it had been my favorites. Because I am a very big sucker for eye creams. If you don't know, I just want to buy eye creams. So this one really worked well for my under eyes. It really reduced my puffiness or little tiredness under my eyes. I don't suffer from heavy dark circles, but this has really given me a considerable difference in my eye look. So get it. If you have any doubt, I've done a full review on Mamaearth products also on my channel, so you can check out and know more about Mamaearth. Next up is a lip sleeping mask. Now this is the Laneige lip sleeping mask. Now I don't buy too many lip sleeping mask or sleeping mask for my skin. I restrict myself on these things because I do a lot of other steps, but lip sleeping masks, I really wanted to get one, and I got this, and I got so obsessed with it that this is the only lip sleeping mask I would recommend anyone or everyone, because this works bomb. If you have dry, chappy lips, and if you wear a lot of lipsticks, and even if you're in winters, non-winters, summers, this is the perfect lip sleeping mask, which can actually work as a good lip balm also. Lip sleeping mask doesn't mean that you are supposed to wear only when you're sleeping or only when you're going in the night to the bed. I wear it whenever I do lip swatches or lipstick and I really want that hydration and nourishment to my lips, I wear this. This really works well. Get it. If you have any doubts, just get it. It's good. Don't have doubts. This is the best sleeping mask I've got. Moving on, another interesting product and an interesting skincare which I love the most, and it's year by year. I've always shown this product in one of my favorites or yearly favorites or current favorites. It's always there in my skincare, is the hand cream. Now, not many people talk high on hand creams, but I'm a person who loves using hand creams because I have super dry hands, and this comes really handy. Earlier I used to buy the smaller sizes, but now I buy the bigger sizes because I feel the amount of hand cream I use, I need a big one. This comes handy. It's good and nourishing. This is by Body Shop. This is in the fragrance Moringa. You can get strawberry, Satsuma, a lot of fragrances are there, but this is much of a milder and a very hydrating hand cream. I've got an inexpensive one also, but this one really made it to my 2019, because this is not only 2019 favorite, this is my lifelong favorite. I've been, from the time I started using hand cream, this was the one I enjoyed the most. Yes, there are many other brands I have not enjoyed any of it, but this one, 10 on 10. Another interesting anti-pollution moisturizer made it to my 2019 favorite. If I haven't been staying in Delhi, I would have never got this, but this made it to my favorites because I used it. It was expensive, but this really does the job. Now, the amount of pollution, the smogginess you have in Delhi, you need something like this for your skin. Earlier I used to feel, oh my god, this is not a extraordinary step to be included. Why do brands make anti-pollution moisturizers or sunscreens and all that? But then when I got this, this made really sense to me, because my skin was really not feeling good, and I used to always feel that my skin is feeling heavy in the air itself. So I got this and I absolutely loved it. Yes, it is expensive, but I feel for your skin care, you can invest this much of money. So this is really nice by Organic Riots. It's an Australian brand. It is available on Nykaa, so get it if you're doubting, because they are really good. I would have never bought this if I would have never faced this issue of pollution and smogginess, but I'm glad that I've tried it. And I must say, even if you're staying in another cities, and we tend to be in too much of pollution nowadays, it's not only Delhi, get something like this included in your skincare. It will really help your skin feel healthy during the day. Before I jump into moisturizers, I would like to show you these three interesting sheet masks which I loved the most during 2019. Yes, 2019 was the year I tried most number of sheet masks from different brands, but the most used, I would say, would be only these three, because there are brands I love the most. The most loved brand during 2019 was Deer Packer, but these three are the ones which I used on regular basis. So I'm going to show you these three. The first one is by Innisfree. This is the tea tree one. I absolutely love this one because this is tea tree, and this is exactly like tea tree by Body Shop. So if I cannot get a sheet mask from Body Shop, definitely the Innisfree one works really well, because when I was in there, when I entered Delhi, it was scorching hot, burning hot, and I need something really cooling for my face which would really work well for my skin. So I got this one, and this really works, and this is a, like an instant relief to your skin, so get it. Now get it, I can say, but if you're not into sheet masks and you have taken a pledge that no more sheet masks, then don't buy. But then this worked really well. So saying that, moving on to another two. One are by Garnier. Now Garnier is a lovely skincare brand for me. Not many people enjoy it, but they nailed their sheet mask. Let me tell you, everybody talks good about it because they really work well. So I got the all the sheet masks I've tried, but the three worked really well for me. I have only two to show you. This is the Garnier Serum Mask Hydro Bomb, and the other one I used the most was Garnier Serum Mask Hydro Bomb. This is a super hydrating one. So these are the two. This is like green and this is like blue. Only I think the flavor is different, but these are the two. These two I got from Big Bazaar Garnier counter, and I got so obsessed with it that I got more from Nykaa later. These will also cost you 99 rupees, but wait for a good offer. You may just end up getting like buy three, get three. So these ones are really good. Again, very high quality. They do what they say. There are many sheet masks I've tried, they dry out your skin, but these ones, they never dried out my skin. So I absolutely love them. Moving on to the last segment is the moisturizers. So I tried a lot of moisturizers during 2019, and one of them is my favorite brand by Garnier. Now, you know, I'm a sucker for Garnier. I love Garnier products. I love their skincare. I am a big hoarder for their skincare. I have used their jars and jars of moisturizers. So these are the three which I have used the most. I don't know which number of tub it is. Maybe it is 20, 25 tub. But this is the Garnier Light Complete Yogurt Night Cream and the Garnier Light Complete Serum Day Cream. Both are bomb degree. If you're looking for something nice, not expensive, lightweight, which will just sit well on your skin, get it. It happens that a lot of you would not agree with me because not everybody likes Garnier. It's the story, like if something works from Garnier on your skin, everything is gonna work. If that one thing doesn't work, nothing is gonna work. Everybody say it, and even I believe it. So they worked really well for me, and they work in any kind of weather. The only the day cream can go a little drying in winters, but night cream would work all season. So get it if you're doubting. They're really amazing. One of my favorites. Lovely. Talking about too much on Garnier, there's another Garnier wrinkle lift which I enjoy the most. This is the Garnier Skin Natural Wrinkle Lift Anti-Aging Cream. Again, absolute love of my life. I don't know which number of tub I'm using this again, 25, 30, I don't know. And I've again repurchased it because it's almost done, and you see the condition of the tub, it's almost done. So yeah, this is another favorite. If you're looking for a very minimalistic, not very expensive anti-aging, anti-wrinkle cream, you can try the Garnier one. It's good quality, not very heavy on the skin. Talking about anti-wrinkle creams, if you are watching me, you know there was another addition to my anti-wrinkle and anti-aging cream was by Himalaya. This is the Himalaya anti-wrinkle cream. This is also amazing. This is like my fourth tub and it's almost done. Only a very tad bit, little bit is left, and I have to repurchase it. This is again very light on skin, not very expensive, worked really well for my skin. It works absolutely well under my makeup. Saying that, we are down to the last moisturizer, which I bought it and I finished it off in 1.5 months, is by Face Shop. And this is the expensive baby. This is their Face Shop Chia Seed No Shine Intense Hydrating Cream. Bomb diggity. Get it. Obviously, it is expensive. It's not easy to get it. But then, if you get a good offer on Face Shop, get this one. If you are a person who wants to invest in a good expensive moisturizer, but if you're a combination to oily or for the matter dry skin, and you're looking for something which is hydrating, which doesn't show up on your skin like a cake, get this one. It's good. It's rightly made. I've tried so many moisturizers from Face Shop during 2019, but I feel personally I've enjoyed this the most, and I will be repurchasing this soon. Hands down, one of the best moisturizers by Face Shop. Face Shop has come out with different variants, but get this one. Specifically, I'm showing you this one because this is really good. By showing you so many interesting skincare, yeah, these were my interesting and holy grails, the favorite of 2019. Most of it I will be using it continuously in my skincare routine. Yes, I will come up with my 2019 upgraded skincare, because yes, a lot has changed. But so far, these were my 2019 favorites. Stay tuned for more such videos on my channel. We'll be back soon with something more interesting, something more exciting. Till then, take care and bye-bye.